You know who my money's on. Us. Have you seen that defense?
Yeah, okay.
All right. Hey, I'm just trying to buy these.
I think you may need one of these, too. I'm just messing with you.
Oh, that was good.
We go.
Enjoy the game.
All right.
Hi, my name is Gabriel Murphy, and I play defensive end for the University of North Texas.
I'm Grayson Murphy. I play defensive end for the University of North Texas.
Is there a way that you can tell them apart?
Not me. Not being around them every single day.
Well, it helps if they have different colored hair, like sometimes they do. That always helps. But when they say identical, they're pretty straight identical to me.
If they have their jerseys on, I know. I know who they are. You know, Gabe is 11, Grayson's 9. But when they're walking, I said, okay, who? And they go 9, 11.
No, I think once you get around them enough and you've been around them a lot, structurally there's some differences in their face.
Some people say that his face is skinnier than mine, and you know, I got a thicker face, so that's one way to tell us apart. Yeah, there is a way to tell us apart. My brother has a scar right here by his eye. It's your right one, right? Yeah, and then it happened, I'm gonna give you the backstory. We was, my mom had just mopped the kitchen, and then we're in the house playing tag.
And you know, I ran into a stool
and split his eye wide open. We had to rush into the emergency room and everything, and that's the score that some people tell him by. We've always been in together since the moment we was born, so you know.
Usually always kind of gravitate towards each other, whether it's in like the classroom, you know, if we have a class together, whether it's on the football field.
You know, I love having a twin. On some days I don't like, you know, always in my personal business and stuff, but
you know, I love his company. You know, sometimes it gets on my nerves, and I'm pretty sure sometimes I get on his nerves.
You know, there's some ups to it and there's some downs to it, but you know, we mainly focus on the ups. You know, it's like having a best friend around you 24/7.
When you were recruiting him, did you always know that if you got one, you're probably going to get the other one?
No, not necessarily. Obviously, you knew you had a good chance with their relationship.
You know, we got a lot of looks from different schools, you know, trying to take one of us or trying to take the other. And then, you know, we got a lot of offers for just one scholarship, but we always told coaches and always told our head coach, you know, don't entertain anybody that doesn't want to take both of us because, you know, we're in it together.
You know, we'd always talked about, you know, growing up that we want to go to college together and, you know, play football together, so.
We liked them both and felt like, you know, just give it the best opportunity of recruiting them and getting to know them and their families.
Well, yeah, in high school, me and my brother played, defensive back, linebacker, and defensive end.
So, you know, coming in my freshman year, we was about 215 pounds, you know, playing linebacker, and we could move. And, you know, during the season, we lost a little weight, you know, got down to like 212, 210. You know, my dad and me and my brother had always discussed we was gonna eventually move into defensive ends at college, because we've always had the frame, but we really didn't have the size, if that makes sense. But we always knew we was gonna get to this size to play at defensive end. Well, my dad knew exactly what it took because he did it back when he was playing football.
Yeah, 4 days a week, 6:30 in the morning. At the end of this guy's fence, they start out and they run to the end of this guy's fence. It's 40 yards. They'd do 12 sprints, 2 warm up at the beginning, 2 warm up at the end. Then we'd break down and do a ladder drill uphill here.
First, our weights started out on our patio, like in the back, you know, the back porch. Then our weights went to our garage, and that's when like we really got serious about it.
All right, this is a quad machine here. They work their quads there, also calves and lightweight squats, and also they'll use it as a military press. This right here is old boxing trick of mine. It's a head harness. You put it on your head, put your weight on there, you work your neck out, just like that right there. They was on that. We'll plug these heaters up. Got 3 of them here, and it'll get a good sweat going. And this is the mat we were talking about where they do their core work. And then we got certain dumbbells here where they do burns on their arms. Over here, of course, is our bench. And all together, we got 435 pounds of weights I had to buy and increase as they got stronger. And of course, this is our squat rack here. And then this right here, those adjustable weights, they use it for curls and military and triceps.
Well, you know, COVID, you know, was a tough time for everybody, but you know, the way we made the most of our situation in COVID is, you know, we worked out every day.
we turned a negative and turned it into a positive. These boys got in here and started grinding, putting that weight on, eating right, working their butts off, and hey, and now, you know, I can honestly say that that's probably one of the reasons they maintained their sanity through this pandemic was this right here in this garage, this weight room.
And he's been very influential in their lives on their training and the discipline he's instilled in them. So I knew they were in good hands.
We put on over like 20, 25 pounds, went up to, from 215 all the way to 240 from my freshman year all to my redshirt freshman year.
I knew that their dad wasn't gonna let them slack off any.
My dad did the perfect plan. We just followed it. Like I said, Coach Womack, you know, refurbished this and made us to the fine machine we are today.
Never quit working, and they just kept progressing through the time.
And then we came back at linebacker, and really wasn't getting the playing time that we wanted at linebacker. So, you know, we transitioned, went to scout team. They put us on scout team, and then we was like, you know, hey, let's try the defensive end. Let's see what we got. Was playing defensive end for 1 week when we were scouting. You know, we was just lighting the offense up. You know, they couldn't do nothing. They couldn't block us.
And they have a really nice knack for making plays inside. So we put them, basically both of them are edge players.
They're big enough and strong enough to be able to set edges in the run game and hold the point, but they're athletic enough to where they can create mismatches on tackles and or moving them inside, getting one-on-one matchup with interior linemen. Competitive comes to mind when I think of those two. Everything they do is about competing and going out there and playing hard and making plays, and they love ball.
Those guys get after it each day, and then they push each other, and you know, they're great for our program.
Their parents should be proud of them because they've been raised right, they're respectful. Football's important to them.
We've dreamed about this moment, and you know, to share it with my brother, you know, I kind of get taken back. You know, just, man, this is just stuff we've dreamed of as kids, you know, to play, you know, at the D1 level, high level that we are right now, and to play defensive end, you know. It's always fun to look across the line and see him on the other side, man. I wouldn't change it for the world.
In the sunshine. Everybody loves the sunshine.